The magnificent human hands. They can build, they can create, they can defend, they can protect, they can treat, they can heal. And they can also get really dirty. I'm cancer physical therapy specialist, Dr. Leslie Waltke. Welcome to the recovery room. Today, we're going to teach you how to wash your hands. Have you noticed that since the time we were toddlers, everybody tells us to wash our hands, wash our hands, wash our hands? But has anybody really stopped to tell us exactly the best way to do that? Today, we're going to learn. Our magnificent but dirty hands can be problematic in several ways. First, they are major transporters of illnesses. Because germs and bugs get on our hands and then we touch our eyes, our nose, and our mouths, these bugs can get into our bodies. Said germs can then make us sick. Salmonella, E. coli, norovirus, and rhinovirus, to name a few, which cause problems like diarrhea, respiratory infections, colds, and more. Secondly, our hands can assist with food cross-contamination. Cut some raw chicken and then cut some spinach without washing our hands in between, and voila, potential food poisoning. And thirdly, some germs can live on household and public surfaces for up to 2 days. So our hands are continuously barraged by germs from other people that don't wash their hands. The world's best defense is not hand washing, but proper hand washing. And here we go. Step one, get your hands wet. The water temperature does not matter. Step two, apply soap, preferably liquid soap, as bar soap, if it sits around too long, can actually harbor germs. Step three, lather and scrub each part of your hands from the wrist to the palms to the knuckles and in between each finger. Step 3.5, continue to wash for about 20 seconds. A common tool is to sing Happy Birthday or the ABC song twice, which should take you about 20 seconds. Step 4, rinse thoroughly, fingers down, to get off the soap and the dirt and the germs. Step 5, dry your hands with a clean towel and then use it to turn off the faucet. If you are exiting a public restroom, always use a towel to open the door to protect yourself from the people that either didn't wash their hands or from the people that didn't wash their hands well enough. And as an extra aside, current evidence is telling us that those handy dandy air bathroom dryers, all they're doing is taking that recirculated dirty bathroom air and blowing it back onto our hands. So current evidence tells us to either use a clean towel to dry our hands or to just let them air dry on their own. I'm cancer physical therapy specialist, Dr. Leslie Waltke, signing out from the recovery room and wishing you happy and clean hands.